Glory is in this place. Hallelujah. This is all the way in the throne. It's your life. You win it. Hallelujah. Yes. He always tells you when he's pleased. There are no pretenses in the glory.
Yeah,
it's not singing. It's heart when you're lined up. Hallelujah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Glory. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for tabernacling with us. Thank you for blessing us with yourself. Nothing is more precious. Hey! Glory to God. We celebrate you, Lord, and we give you the glory and the praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah! On a Wednesday night, come on, how many of you are winning? Look at all the hands. You are touched by his heart, touched by his love.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, can you give him a wave with both hands? Come on, flow with the music. Yay. Lord, we worship you. We acknowledge you. We give you praise. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for blessing us. You are all we have. And when you are with us, we can overcome any devil, any mountain, any principality, any power. Yay! Thank you, thank you, thank you. Come on, thank him for yourself. Thank him. Thank him for blessing you. Thank him for restoring your worship. Thank him for joy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, high five somebody. Say, man, I'm celebrating the presence of God in this place. Hallelujah. Glory. In a court worship. Hallelujah. God bless you. You may be seated. This worship that just happened is not an accident. Some things were fixed on that altar. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You can sing the same song. Amen. But when he's pleased, he will ride on it. That's our guarantee that our prayers will be answered. We'll be delivered from the hand of the enemy. We will overcome every mountain, scale every valley. Hallelujah. Reach our destiny. This is your midweek tune-up. Hallelujah. You have to stay in worship all week long. You have to check your heart. Okay, am I still worshiping? Or am I back to mumbling and complaining? Check yourself every day. Yeah? You just worship. Make sure you still got your shout. Amen. Glory to God. Jesus discipled 12 men. He lost one. He knew he would lose him from the beginning. He told him, I chose you 12. I'm one of you. He's a devil. So there was no issue. But the 11 that he left, hallelujah, changed the world. Amen. I'm always tickled when I look at man's attempt to fix God. The apostles decided on their own that they needed to replace Judas. And they cast lot and chose Matthias. and put him in place of Judas. Did anyone read of Matthias anywhere? What they did not know was that the apostolic call will grow, not from the people, but from the house of Joseph. Jesus' siblings, James, and his brothers were the apostles. Hallelujah. When you learn these things, you know, I got goosebumps talking about. They were in the house. They didn't believe he was the Messiah. But yet their destiny was apostleship. I celebrate the presence of God, not only for what he will do for us, but for what we will become in him. There's no way this rain can be falling on me and I remain the same. Something must change. Something must give. Yoke must break. I must become.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There's something going on in here tonight. You might not know it, but I'm telling you, something special is going on in here. Watch. Three times I've come over here, and it looks like somebody's over there. And I look up, I don't see anybody, but when I turn, I see him. That must be an angel on this altar. Right there. Three times. I see a man all like this in white. Over, I keep turning around, but I don't see anybody. When I look, I saw you see him again. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. He's my master. He's my savior. He's my father. Glory. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Thank you. Hallelujah. I'm not rushing ahead. I'm going to let him have his way. Break every yoke, Lord. Restore every one of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yay. Glory. You must know that the path of destiny is tortuous, is winding. But there's one guarantee. God is faithful and true. He will get us there. We might be stumbling, falling, skinning our knees, but He will get us there. If we give Him the heart to produce the breakthrough. God goes by a man's heart. Hallelujah. See? I saw him again. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. 11 men changed the world. Don't you see? That's why I'm crying out for sons of God to show up. How can we have millions and millions of people, but very few sons of God on the earth? One son of God can change a nation. Hallelujah. May He find us true sons of God to get the work job done in this end time. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. That's what He wants. Even if you're having stadium crusades and all of a sudden the singers are lined up, what are you talking about? Even before you get to me, miracles will be happening. Yeah. Angels will be flying everywhere. Glory to God. That's why the enemy is warring against us. I told you, God said, you see now, these young ladies you see on stage, He said, those are the people I will use. So that's why the enemy is fighting them. But as worship was going on, this scripture came to me. He said, the children I've given to you, they are for signs and wonders. Signs, wonders, and miracles. They will sing it down as I will preach it down. Hey. Glory. Glory to God. The enemy is wasting his time fighting. The counsel of the Lord shall stand. Shall stand. When I look into Abraham's family, I don't see any perfect anything. Look in David's family, I don't see any perfect anything. But God still got the job done. So much so, Jesus is sitting on the throne of David. Can you believe it? How can God sit on the throne of a man? Because the man's throne and his heart were the same. So the Lord can be comfortable sitting on his throne, knowing that nothing is coming from there to mess with him. I was telling my children that, I said, you don't understand what's going on. Yes, you may have this battle, that battle. Sometimes they tell me, oh, you know, praise wasn't all of that. I said, you don't understand. But since you started doing this, every time I come up here, I haven't had to fight any devils. Every time I hit the stage, the prophetic explodes. Hooray! Hallelujah! I celebrate the faithfulness of God. Come on, shout like it. Hallelujah! So that's why I'm teaching you my faith, so you can follow it and replicate it. So whatever generation that is left after us, they know what resurrection is and they can effect it. Amen. And when somebody comes up and starts an intellectual, they say, no, 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 that is not resurrection. You don't have to wonder who should pastor the church after me. You know it by resurrection grace. Amen. They will carry the same grace. Amen. It's not oratory. It's a permanent, resident grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Beloved, one of the most important lessons I believe that the current church must learn is to understand the patterns of God. If you look at Deuteronomy, God said to the nation of Israel, you should remember all the ways the Lord your God led you this 40 years. I cry, I agonize because people waste experiences. People are rushing to get out of things and they haven't learned anything about God. They haven't understood what was wrong or what was corrected for things to work. Get me out, get me out, get me out. And they come out empty-handed. Okay, you got a nice job. Now what? You've been broke for a while. Now you got a job. So what? What did you learn about God? Could you replicate your breakthrough by teaching someone else what you learned? That is the pattern of God's covenant. God shows you the pattern. Then you imitate it, and then you teach others. And you have a generation, hallelujah. I celebrate resurrection agents. All around the world. Catch them anywhere. Don't worry about the fake ones. The real resurrection agents, they're respectful, they're loving, they're anointed, they walk in faith. Hallelujah. They're blessed. Glory to God. We know them by their fruit. We don't know them by their numbers. Their fruit. Their fruit. Glory to God. God puts the seal of his approval by his glory. When he attaches his presence on something, that's the greatest blessing you can ever receive in this life. Unfortunately, most of you refuse to be taught. You go to churches and it's all a boring routine. Church is just emotions. You make noise and go. No beans about the spirit life. What are we going to do? A generation lost. Generation that cannot stand up for God. And when I listen to leaders and listen to people, I wonder, do you all pray? Which God are you listening to? Is it the same one that's talking to me? I pray that your story will change hearing the word of resurrection. Isn't that an exciting thought that God went ahead of me and reserved a building for me 7 years before I finally got to it? We're sitting in it now broadcasting to you. Wow. In 4 years, I paid it off. I was thinking about it, 21 years into this church, and I've been debt-free 17 years of those 21 years. Show me that anywhere in America, even the massive churches with all their millions. Many of them are in debt to their eyeballs. Glory, glory, glory. May he change you forever. write me today. Connect with Resurrection Glory. Connect with Resurrection Grace. The address is on your screen. I can spell it out for you in case you have any kind of handicap. P.O. Box 251, Union City, Georgia, 30291. Amen. Connect with Resurrection Power and Grace. You'll be transformed. Put your seed in the ground. Jesus taught me. He said, son, I will show you how the power of my kingdom is released. I said, how? He said, through seed. Not the one someone tells you, but the one I tell you. And he gave me a number and I acted on it. And my life was changed forever. So when I hear so-called preachers speaking against tithing or sowing seed, I saw one guy and his video was all over the place. If a preacher tells you to sow $1,000, that's a lie, that's a lie. I say, he's as light as his words. He don't know what he's talking about. He's broke and full of bills to his eyeballs. If you have tasted the glory, you will not say such a thing. You know the power of seed. When Brother Copeland said, you know, he kept believing God for his airplane and just couldn't, his faith couldn't lock in. And the unbelief kept interfering. And he took $1,000,000 and put into Ron High Bank his ministries to buy the tent. And he jumped on a flight and went to see the tent. He said, as soon as I saw that tent, my faith locked in. And Citation 10 popped out of nowhere. Cash. Hey. Ooh, I have goosebumps. Hey, you connect with men that have tasted the glory. Get away from all these chickens making noise in Atlanta and everywhere. Sons of God will arise. We will take America back. These liberals have no chance. One decree. We'll set the record straight. Amen. Ooh, I'm way past time. Love you guys. It's a blessing. See you Sunday morning if you come to worship with us. Otherwise, Monday morning right here on the Voice of Resurrection, I got a special word for you. It will change your life forever. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Oh, see you Monday. Bye-bye. When dead things come.